Good afternoon, Cross Timbers. Today is July 7th, 2016. This is Texan TV News from the Tarleton State University campus in Stephenville, Texas. I'm Sammie Wight. Here are today's top stories. In campus news, Tarleton State University gets an endowment scholarship. Select incoming students without the funds can look forward to the possibility of attending duck camp next summer without having to pay much of the registration fee. A $15,000 endowment scholarship for duck camp was presented Wednesday by Tarleton State University President Dominic F. DiTavio. The scholarship is a first-time donation from Kelly Doggett, a local physician, and Karen Kime, branch manager at Members Trust Federal Credit Union. This endowment will help Tarleton State University students who cannot afford the cost to cover the camp registration fee. Vice President for Student Life Laura Boren and President DiTavio shared their enthusiasm for the endowed award.
The endowment that we just created for Duck Camp is very special because it's a gift that keeps on giving to future generations of Tarleton Duck Campers. And I think, as most students know, Duck Camp is a signature piece of who we are, cementing our traditions and our values and real respect across the campus. As you can tell, we're excited back there and we're excited about this endowment.
In local news, according to the Stephenville Empire Tribune, the Stephenville City Council's Public Works Committee is at work on a new ordinance governing how the city provides water and sewer services outside the city limits. The matter was on Tuesday's City Council agenda, but as Mayor Kenny Weldon explained, quote, "We need to do some more work on this, so it's going back to committee," and no action was taken. As written now, the new ordinance would repeal others passed in 1993 and provide water and sewer services for commercial, industrial, or residential customers outside the city limits only after the applicant submits a formal contract for those services. Unless the new ordinance is amended by the Public Works Committee, applicants must apply for both water and sewer services, not just one or the other. Also, the rate for such services, again as the proposed ordinance reads now, would be 1.15 times the rate being currently charged within the city limits. However, should the city annex the area being serviced outside the city limits, the rate would then revert to the rate being charged to city customers. In state news, Texas and nationwide retail gasoline prices have slipped 3 cents per gallon this week. AAA Texas on Thursday reported the statewide average at the pump was $2.09 per gallon. Drivers across the U.S. are paying an average $2.26 per gallon. Amarillo has the cheapest gasoline in Texas this week at an average $1.96 per gallon. The association survey found El Paso with the most expensive gasoline statewide this week at $2.16 per gallon. AAA estimates 43 million drivers hit the road over the 4th of July holiday weekend. Association officials say higher demand has put upward pressure on gasoline prices. In national news, we turn to the AP News Minute video.
This is AP News Minute. A second video has emerged showing the fatal police shooting of Alton Sterling in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, early Tuesday. Hundreds attended a vigil for Sterling on Wednesday, where Sterling's aunt called for protesters to stay peaceful. Police in Minnesota say a man has died after an officer shot him. Authorities say the man was shot while in his car with a woman and child also inside. FBI Director James Comey heads to Capitol Hill on Thursday. House Republicans want to question him about why he did not recommend charges against presumptive Democratic nominee Hillary Clinton for her handling of classified email. And three new crew members are on their way to the International Space Station. A rocket blasted off from Kazakhstan on Thursday with crew members from the U.S., Russia, and Japan. Sandy Kozell, The Associated Press, with AP News Minute.
In international news, the Associated Press reports preparations were underway in Taiwan on Thursday as a powerful typhoon threatens the country's eastern coast. Authorities issued a land warning and warned residents on the coast to take precautions against the strong wind and torrential rain as the fast-moving typhoon Nipartak approached. Typhoon Nipartak slowed and weakened slightly Thursday afternoon but remained dangerous, packing maximum sustained winds of 127 miles per hour and gusts of 149 miles an hour. It was blowing at sea about 99 miles northeast of Itbayat Town in the northernmost Philippine province of Bataan, with a large rain diameter of 403 miles, according to the Philippine Weather Agency. It is forecast to make landfall Friday morning south of Hualien City in eastern Taiwan. Big waves are already lashing the shore of nearby Ilan Port City, where fishermen tightened their boats. Forecasters said waves of 3 to 24 feet could batter the coast, inland lakes, and beachfront areas. Today's weather forecast comes from weather.com. You can expect an abundant amount of sunshine with the high at 99 degrees, the humidity level at 46%, and winds coming from the south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight will be a low of 73 degrees with a few passing clouds, humidity at 65%, and winds coming south at 10 to 20 miles an hour. Today's broadcast is produced by Brendan Korn and Rebecca Hernandez. You can watch Texan TV live on weekdays on Northland Cable Channel 9 and on Channel 2.1 in all residence halls. Don't forget to follow Texan News Service on Facebook and Twitter, and check out our website at www.texannews.net. Tune in every Thursday for the latest news from the Tarleton State University campus in Stephenville, Texas.